two of the most important materials in our society are iron and aluminium. But the production of these two metals have very strong negative impacts on the environment. The iron and steel making sectors are responsible for approximately 8% of all CO2 emissions on the planet. The primary synthesis of aluminium, in turn, is followed by the formation of a very aggressive byproduct called red mud. Red mud is a reddish slurry that contains a complex mixture of different oxides, traces of heavy and precious metals. Among these components that are present inside the red mud, iron oxides can be present up to 6%. Nowadays, the total amount of red mud produced around the globe pile up to the gigantic value of 4 billion tons. So, my research question is now how to extract iron from the red mud using an alternative and sustainable synthesis route that involves hydrogen plasma. To extract iron from red mud, we use hydrogen plasma species as a reduced agent to convert iron oxides that is contained in red mud into metallic iron. For that, we use a conventional electric arc furnace, which is equipped with a water-cooled copper hearth where we introduce or replace the material to be processed, and an electrode sitting right above of the material. We then ignite an electric arc between the tip of the electrode and the material to be processed. And inside this arc, electrons can collide with hydrogen molecules and even argon. And the product of these collisions is that hydrogen can be broken apart as hydrogen plasma species, as atoms or even protons. When this species exceeds close to the reaction interface between the material and the arc, the iron oxides get preferably reduced by hydrogen, leading to metallic iron inside the volume of the material to be processed, and the byproduct is water. The temperature of such arcs are high enough to melt the material. This means that the hydrogen plasma approach permits us to simultaneously melt and reduce the material in one single step. Once we switch off the arc, the sample gets solidified inside the furnace, and we take it for posterior characterization. We use the sample, for example, to analyze the microstructure evolution, the chemical evolution of it, chemical partitioning between different phases inside the material, and of course to evaluate how much iron was produced and how much we still can extract from the volume that we are processing. The key findings of our research was that the direct exposure of solid red mud to a hydrogen plasma allowed us to transform the solid material into a very viscous oxide liquid. Inside this viscous liquid, the regions which are very much enriched in iron gets preferably reduced by hydrogen species into pure iron. And this pure iron, which is liquid, coalesces in the form of perfect spheres inside of the entire volume of material. There is a complete mass separation between these two types of liquids because of their difference in terms of viscosity and density. Specifically for our experiments, we use a red mud which originally contained 40% of iron oxides. The remaining parts were aluminum oxides, silicon oxides, titanium oxides, calcium and sodium oxides as well. By reducing the material with hydrogen plasma, we found that only 10 minutes of process was enough to convert 6% of all iron atoms of the original red mud into metal. This metal is pure enough at this point already to be used for steel production. We also found that the remaining oxides react among themselves and transform into a glassy structure when solidified. This subproduct has a neutral character, which is pretty much different from the very aggressive alkaline red mud, and opens new possibilities for using this subproduct in constructions, for example. Why our research is relevant? It opens the path for a circular economy in metal industries where we are converting a very toxic and unwanted byproduct into materials of technological importance as iron and materials for construction. So the steel industry is responsible for approximately 8% of all CO2 emissions on the planet. if we can start using red mud as a complementary feedstock for iron production, we can use the 4 billion tons of red mud that is already piled up around the globe to produce around 600 million tons of iron. Our hydrogen plasma approach establishes a sustainable connection between the waste management of aluminum industry and the CO2 emissions of iron industry. We found that we can produce iron in one single step process in which the solid red mud can be fed into these hydrogen plasma reactors and be converted into sustainable products like iron and materials for construction ends. We now take these findings and try to understand in high detail the chemical mechanisms that drive these chemical reactions. We try to understand, for example, which oxides enhance or retard the reduction of iron oxide into iron, and the role of these elements into the value of viscosity of our product. This is pretty much important for us to guarantee a proper mass separation between the oxide liquid and the metal liquid. To solve the problem of red mud piling up around the globe and to convert this into a benefit for industry and mankind, it's imperative that we researchers team up with different industries, particularly the aluminum and the steel industry, so then we can start thinking of scaling this process up, making use of existing electric arc furnaces.